this policy brief was written by the comrades and addressed to the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, stating that the economic cost of drug incarceration is considered higher than the cost associated with the drug use. Who are the comrades? The comrades is a group of aspiring young youth who sees, knows, and understands the menace of illicit drugs in Nigeria and also the world, and who seeks a way to help drug-addicted individuals get back their life, get back their health, and also get back their responsibility. However, despite the fact that parents and law enforcement agencies say no to drug, my stance still remains that certain illicit drugs should be legalized and marijuana should be decriminalized. Yeah, let's travel far back in time. In the 1980s and 1990s, Nigeria dominated various criminal organizations active in so many countries and thus became a key player in the international smuggling of heroin, particularly into the United States of America. And according to the World Drug Report of 2007, this business of international smuggling of heroin and other drugs is a thriving business that is worth $322 billion. And according to the Nigerian Prison Service statistics, out of 143 prisoners in 5 prisons, 25% of them are tested positive for cannabis use. Still far back in time, in 1984, at the emergence of a military head of state in Nigeria, he enacted some decree that anybody who is found with the use of cocaine or any similar drugs, or even buying, selling, or possessing this cocaine or any similar drugs, shall be convicted and suffer death by firing squad. This, however, caught up with some 3 Nigerians, but due to a lot of disapproval by people and the populace of Nigeria, this was later replaced by various jail times, ranging from 2 years to life imprisonment. However, despite the creation of the Nigerian Drug Law Enforcement Agency in 1989 and all other support from the Nigerian Police Force, the Nigerian Immigration Service, and even the Nigerian Customs Service, drug problem in Nigeria has never for once reduced, but instead, it keeps going high. And if this drug problem continues advancing as it is, very soon we will be faced with some frightening options which would have been best controlled if critical decisions and actions are taken now. I repeat, if critical decisions and actions are taken now. In 2011, the UNODC published its reported war on drugs and explained its failure on the war on drugs. As a result of this, I acknowledge the fact that drug-addicted individuals shouldn't be treated as criminals. Neither should we stigmatize them, but we should treat them like patients. We should show them love. We should show them care. This, however, made some 4 recommendations, which are as follows. 1, sales and quantity imposition should be based on age. A young adult in Nigeria starts from the age of 18. So at the age of 18, a young adult in Nigeria should be able to use, buy, possess these illicit drugs. 2, a buyer should be required to be a member of a group prior to purchase. Series of groups should be started up. Since we have over 250 ethnic groups in Nigeria, these groups can however be divided into 250 ethnic groups. All this is to bring about efficiency and effectiveness. 3, registration, training, and licensing of purchasers. Purchasers should be registered with their various group so that it will allow for easy tracking of these purchasers. And all this is still to discourage drug use, raise addiction concern, and give possible treatment. 4, there should be shared responsibility between the producer, the consumer, and the heads of the member group. For instance, if somebody gets intoxicated because of the use of these illicit drugs and gets involved in one accident or the other, he alone shouldn't be held responsible for this, but the seller should be held responsible, and the head of the member group should also be held responsible for this. All this I've been saying this morning can be summarized into what I personally term drug environment. This drug environment explains that a young adult at the age of 18 should be liberal to use drugs, sell or possess these drugs just by simply following some basic rules, which are registering as a user, attempting exams, if passed, should be allowed to use these substances, and if failed, should go back for re-education and training. And anybody before the age of 18 should be monitored adequately by the parents. And anybody who defaults this law shouldn't be treated with levity, but should face law properly. I, as a member of Comrades, hereby conclude that Regulation of illicit drugs and decriminalization of marijuana, a credible choice out of several alternatives, may not be the best for a drug-accustomed economy. Neither is it a total solution or panacea to the high cost of incarceration. But I'm willing to tell you that this same policy recommendation has been tried in Spain, and it has worked. It has been tried in Portugal, it has worked. It has been tried in Italy, and it has worked. So I'm telling you today that even if it is tried in Nigeria, it is going to work perfectly. Thank you all for the opportunity given to me for this speech. Thank you. Yes. I would like to talk about the limitations and how to circumvent this risk. And I would like to talk about some misconceptions too. Well, the limitations can be the cost incurred in this policy recommendation. Another thing can be the implementation of this policy recommendation. It can be so cumbersome. So let me start from the cumbersome aspect. This policy recommendation can be so cumbersome, but due to the kind of federalized system we have in Nigeria, it can be delimited, it can be divided, and this responsibility can be given to the state government. The federal government alone shouldn't implement this, but it should be given to the state government. And this state government can go further to distribute this responsibility to the local government. And as I said earlier, the local government can then distribute this responsibility to the member groups, which serves as the union, so to say. And these member groups can also distribute these responsibilities to probably religious leaders and so on and so forth. Another thing is the cost. The limitation is the cost. The cost incurred in this recommended policy is a little bit high in the sense that, but still, this cost is nothing compared to the cost incurred in the war on drugs. So I think. All right,
you don't want to